Welcome to yet another show of Fit with Mithraas with Shiva Yoga Center. We have Dr. Bhuvana here, and we've been doing the series of yoga poses, and we've been also talking about the clothing and everything else. So today we'll talk about the situations, who can do and who should not do, and when can we do, especially for women during the periods, is it okay to do or not okay to do, or is there any particular poses that they have to do during periods?
Okay. So yoga practice should be preferably done early in the morning, between like 4:30, 5:30, 6:30, and if you are not able to wake up so early, you can push to 9 o'clock, but make sure that you don't go beyond 10 o'clock. Okay, and if you're doing early in the morning, on an empty stomach is suggested.
I'm sorry to break you here. So you say don't go beyond 10 o'clock, right? But what if people who are working in the night shifts?
For those people, no. The outer limit is max 10 a.m. or 10:30. Mm-hmm. And don't go beyond that. And if they are comfortable, they can even start the practice by evening 4:30, 5:30.
As they wake up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You practice on an empty stomach. But if you practice, and again what you asked the question, if you are in a night shift and you want to do the yoga practice say around morning 9:30 a.m, have very little breakfast, like porridge or an apple or some fruit salad or vegetable salad. Don't make your tummy full with your breakfast, and don't starve. Okay, because certain practices when you do, you will feel like dizzy and you'll start shivering. So for them, little breakfast is suggested. And early morning practice, I always recommend my students to have a glass of lukewarm water or with half
lemon,
a few drops of lemon with the honey. Okay, and people who are suffering from gastritis, I make sure that they come to the early morning practice after having an apple or one banana.
Oh, something in the stomach, very little.
Yeah, very little in their stomach. And banana is soothing for the the esophageal tract, and likewise apple also. So these are the conditions for yoga practice. You don't need anything other than a yoga mat and the individual, and well ventilated place with good air, and make sure studios with practicing with AC on. So it is not advisable to practice with AC on.
So what about this women with periods?
People who are like in their menstrual period, it depends upon their individual's body reaction. For
otherwise, it is generally advised.
I generally suggest they can do pranayams. They
other
can
than
do
some of the asanas.
Asanas. Okay. Intermediate asanas. Mm-hmm. Simple warm-ups and asanas.
So what is that we are going to see today, Dr. Bhuvana?
And today's session is all about prone postures. Mm-hmm. So prone postures is nothing but lying down on your stomach.
Okay.
And in that, we'll be doing three different postures. The first one is called Bhujangasan, which is called Cobra. Okay. The second one is called the Locust Pose, Shalabhasan. And the third one is called Makrasana or the Crocodile Posture.
Mm-hmm. I'm not taking further on time, so let's move on to Bhuvana and her students. Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome to yet another show, Fit with Mithraas, Shiva Yoga Center. In this episode, we are going to give a demo for prone postures. Prone postures is nothing but lying down on your stomach. And in this segment, there are three asanas. The first one is called the Cobra Pose, the Bhujangasana. The second one is called the Locust Pose, Shalabhasan. And the third one is called the Crocodile Pose, Makarasan. So, shall we get started, Niranjani? Yes. Lie down on your stomach. Yes. We'll do a simple warm-up. Extend the hands to the sides, Niranjani. Okay. Before we get into the asanas, it is important you do upasanas. Upasana is nothing but loosening practices. Okay, knees bent, straight. Continue for 5 rounds. Now, very slowly, bring your palms closer to your chest. So, her feet are together and viewers, just watch how she is going to come for Bhujangasana. Make sure that you place your elbows closer to your rib cage and inhale very slowly up. Yes, stop at the chest level and hold in this posture with normal breathing. 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. Exhale very slowly down. People who have acute back pain, there is yet another variation. Slowly bring your palms in front. This is called Sphinx pose. Yes, extend your hands, Niranjani. Yeah. Now make sure that you maintain a shoulder gap and very slowly come up. Elbow should be in shoulder gap and this is called a Sphinx pose. So the benefits that we get out of Cobra, the same benefits you will be getting while doing the Sphinx pose. This will make your spine supple and you will be getting rid of the back pain. Okay, so relax. Yes, so the next one is called Shalabhasana. Now for this, place your palms underneath your thighs. It's called locust pose. We'll be doing with our right leg first, then we'll be doing with our left leg. Inhale and raise your right leg up. Support your right thigh muscle with your right palm. And viewers, you can hold this posture at your own comfortable pace. Like if you're not able to lift your legs up at this level, you can even start with a little down. This is also good and this is one of the best asana for low back pain. 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. Very slowly bring your right leg down. Now she is going to continue the same with her left leg. Inhale and lift the leg up. And hold this posture for a count of 5. Normal breathing. Make sure you don't lift your head. Your chin should be tucked onto the mat and you don't tense your shoulders. 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. Very slowly bring your left leg down. Now relax. Release your hands. Yes. The limitations of this asana is people who have recent abdominal surgery and people who are in their menstrual cycle need not practice this Shalabhasana. Okay, the next asana is called Makarasana. Slowly place your gently come up at the chest level. Place your support your elbows and place your left palm on the right shoulder and right palm on the left shoulder and extend your legs sideways. Make sure your toes are pointed out and your heels are pointed in. Relax in this posture. This is called a relaxing posture and stay with normal breathing. 5, 4, 3, 2 and 1. Slowly down, relax. Yes, Makarasana. Limitations, people who are in their menstrual cycle and people who are recent abdominal surgery, hernia, these people need not practice Makarasana because your tummy is pressed onto the mat. So this will cause further damage for your ailments. So people who are suffering from menstrual cycle and people who are suffering from recent abdominal surgery, hernia, etc. need not practice. Others may practice. So today's session, it was prone postures, and in this session we saw three asanas. The first one was Bhujangasana, the second one was locust posture, Shalabhasana, and the third one was Makarasana. Thank you, viewers.